3 out of 5. Where is Wraith?
So this is best 3 out of 5.
Right, it's Bayonetta Meta Knight. So what do you think of this matchup?
This matchup, this is one I don't see too much of. I mean, Bayonetta can always escape from Meta Knight's combos with that silly little bat within thing of hers.
Yeah.
But I feel like this matchup is definitely doable for both characters, honestly, though.
Is Meta Knight able to land that up air combo on
him? He can if he gets a footstool set up into a jab lock.
Uh-huh.
That's what I feel, though, only because, like I said, Bat Within can definitely save people, like we just saw there.
Yeah.
If Meta Knight has to try to do his combos a little bit more differently, though, mm-hmm. if he is to go ham on Bayonetta, so like and he could just do heebie-jeebies. What did we see there?
He dropped his controller, maybe. We don't know.
All I'm gonna say though is just be like, okay, Dante is calling your name. She's like, I'm coming, or something. Maybe that's probably it. Who knows?
Unfortunate botch. Now this could mean some problems for Bayonetta now, having to come back and have to get two stocks now.
Oh my goodness.
And this does not look good for Wraith.
Right? Yeah. Freaking Riz is just dominating the neutral game right now.
Wow. What a good sequence of perfect shields right there.
I've never seen that happen like so many times ever. It's like watching two Dragon Ball Z fighters go at it.
Yeah, and Riz takes the first game with a well done forward smash. Perfectly cooked.
Very well done.
Yeah.
So we are definitely
3 out of 5
or something.
5 out of 7.
Alright,
Ah, looks like we're having some time constraints right here.
So which one are we going by? 3 out of 5?
Oh, so
interesting.
It's always fun to watch a Ryu, I'd say.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Recently, Trella had retired from competitive Smash,
mm-hmm.
whatever, which is unfortunate for us, though, because he was definitely considered by many to be heavily regarded as the best Ryu player.
But we did see one in Civil War, right?
Yeah, he was there at Civil War, Locust was there at Civil War.
Locust, there we go.
And every Ryu playing is just really good in their own ways, and each of them just plays completely different, though, honestly. Now, I feel the reason why this matchup is like that, though, is because Ryu definitely gives Meta Knight a run for his money, because he just has a bit more combo potential.
Yeah,
so.
But the thing is here, Ryu's weakness are multi-hit moves, usually because they can break your down B.
Okay.
That's something Meta Knight has.
Badly.
Back here and forward, right?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Meta Knight has a couple things that can break that. Ryu can definitely get some up tilt strings if anything, though, mm-hmm. like soft up tilt.
Yeah, you're right.
So he can just do like the thing with like his little elbow thing like that, though, like
one little up tilt to like down there.
Up into the down there.
Like how we're seeing right there.
Yeah, that right there is the neck breaker, which is the
shield
break option that Ryu has. That is rather good for the most part, and. That one, though, I will say right there, though, if there's an insta-shield thing, though, that makes the matchup for, Jigglypuff forever almost, like, super bad.
Yes.
But, like, as long as it's not Marty, okay, so there's always that.
Ooh, and that, oh.
At 86, wow, I've never seen a kill so Yeah, Meta Knight does have enough rage, though, to help him with getting those early kills, because of the fact, though, that he is able to get those kills so early.
Yeah.
And
looks
because
like Wraith here is losing patience and throwing a upbeat right there.
Yeah. But if he loses this game, though, do you think he will go real, or do you think that he will still stick to Bayonetta?
My advice would be for him to stick Bayonetta and put up a better game if it wasn't for that little SD.
Ow.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he got a bit of a kill there, though, so Wraith just has to try to, in game or two, to reset the bracket, and Riz is one game away from just taking this tournament. So, this just goes to show you that you really have to try to quickly adjust though, if you're in a game 3 scenario anyway.
Now, Bayonetta on FD.
Let's go, Riz.
Bayonetta on FD. How does this look?
This one, on the other hand though, it can go either way, honestly though.
Can she land the combos?
Can Bayo land combos? Bayo can definitely land her combos here, except like, despite that this is breeding space, both characters can definitely do that though. They just have to be a bit situational with it, because it's like, with Bayonetta's combos, it's all dependent on where they DI. Bayonetta can just like try to do the thing all day. Mm-hmm. And we have seen like the past couple of games or whatnot where like whenever we see Meta Knight on FD, he has taken games off our Hungry whenever he has played on the stage because, well, he was just able to get those kills better because he wanted to make sure though that when he's there, he just is getting to extend.
Yeah, let's see what Bayonetta can do. And that's, wow, wonderful tech by Riz.
Very wonderful. Like, I felt that almost could have been it again. Questionable force smash right there.
Trying to go for a hard read, maybe cover a landing, but it wasn't spaced enough.
Probably. I feel like right now, Meta Knight's trying to like get a little bit more momentum right now.
Mm-hmm.
Like just as Bayonetta was having it like some time ago.
Yeah, but now Bayonetta with an up smash taking out Riz's first stock.
Yeah, right now we are seeing that Wraith currently right now has momentum in the game, and Meta Knight just needs to play it safe. And what I like that Riz is doing is that he's using forward smash to apply pressure to what Wraith is going through, because you want to make certain that you are always applying pressure with Meta Knight at all times though. And I know it's a little bit cheesy to always like brought your smashes and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But
that's something you see a lot from Riz. Sometimes he'll try to get you with that forward smash. He'll just charge it up and hope you win.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Like the whole idea of this though is to make for Meta Knight though is just to try to bait out unsafe habits though that Wraith is doing though, and that's why you can tell he's just fishing out for his forward smashes, so like he just wants it.
But how safe would you say his forward smash is?
No lag on the spot.
No lag.
No lag on the spot, but it's slow on startup. It's slow on startup though, but if you do it afterwards though, you can do whatever, like you saw there. You can literally mix up your opponent with like any way possible. You can either do it again and again, or you can space it out and do it again, or you can just follow up with a grab and do just about whatever you need.
So it's a good baiting tool.
It's a really good baiting and pressure tool.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you're doing that though, you never know like what you're trying to do with whatever the character's trying to do. So
and now Bayonetta with the commanding lead. And ended up Riz's stock right there, so now it is 2-1.
Yeah, so it's not a clean 3-0, mm-hmm. which that would have been...
We would have thought that might have been the case here, but...
Yeah, no. But luckily, though, there's a possibility, though, that we might see either a reverse 3-0, mm-hmm. or...
It might just end here.
We could just end right here, though. Like, right now, we definitely have seen that Bayonetta has been the better option for this set, rather than Ryu. Even though Ryu does have a bit more fun with fighting Meta Knight, honestly though, like you can tell that though that Wraith's Bayo is doing a lot more adjusting to what is needed to be done in the neutral game right now. So right now we are on game 4, I believe.
This is game 4. It's 2-1 right now. Riz has one game left. Wraith has two games to go.
Two games to go and a reset.
And a reset, yes.
Which
Wraith
means
it still has a pretty long road.
Yeah, which means it's a bit more pressuring that way, because like the thing about bracket resets though is like you either still have your momentum or you just lose your composure completely, because it would just drain it out of you. Oh, what are we seeing here?
Wow, nice combo
with
right
49.
There.
Mm-hmm. Good stuff right there to Wraith.
Yeah, looks like Wraith has picked up a lot of momentum here, and we might see a bracket reset.
This may be possible, though. Mm-hmm. Like, right now, I feel like this is still anybody's game, and you just never know what will probably commence, and interesting upbeat there. I mean, probably would have killed, though. And
Riz looks like he's losing his patience a little bit, going for some extremely unsafe moves. And here we have Wraith capitalizing on that.
Yeah, Wraith, what Wraith is doing though is just capitalizing on like all the options that Meta Knight is doing, and what they are not seeing Meta Knight really do enough though is like trying to apply pressure to Bayonetta. And the fact though that there's no pressure being applied to is probably what's the biggest struggle of this game right now. So
will that kill? No, Wraith going for Riz going for an edge guard there, but didn't seem to work. And ooh, the dimensional cape could have killed there.
Yeah, it would have been like a really, really hard read though, but mm-hmm. would have taken a teleport thing though, so either or it's okay.
Yeah. So do you think here right now Wraith has the download on Ridge? Because he's doing a lot better than what he was doing the first two games.
100%. Like, you can tell he's just going back and wow, we got a game 5.
Game 5.
Will this be a back air reset?
You see what happened there? Side B to back air. And though you didn't get the little red flash, so was that bad DI on Riz's part?
Well, there was a little bit of rage in there, so you can tell that. So you can tell. It's because of the rage mechanic though, but then again, Bayonetta's back air is rather strong in that way though, so we can definitely just keep that into perspective. So we're now going into game 5
game
right now.
Game 5 on Smash Bros. It could all end here, or we could go to another set, there we go.
So, like, either or can happen though. Like right now, Wraith has definitely been doing a lot better on neutral because he has been able to adjust what needs to be
done. That is not good.
He got him with the women's rights.
Yep, he just stomped on him.
Exactly. The only reason I call it that though is because like whenever she does a down smash, she like poses like a woman. She's like, I'm...
That was a heel to the head and he's dead.
Exactly. Like, right now, this is looking very capable, like a bracket reset for the most part.
And yes, it is.
This is no. Okay. One miracle at a time.
Yeah. Wraith bringing it back. Riz is not giving up though.
Yeah,
he's not letting this end so easily.
He's trying to make sure everything is hard, bro.
No, unfortunately, we have the bracket reset.
My goodness.
What Riz needs to do now is just put that in the controller, take a deep breath, clear his mind.
Just breathe, relax, think happy thoughts, think meditation.
Exactly.
Think of that one, think of like the last time you ever went on a date with a girl and it turned out amazing, whatever, and then you probably did a little more than just Smash, but that's besides the point. Anyway, so we are now in the bracket reset at the moment though, so this could be interesting because, well, after seeing like how much momentum Wraith was able to get within the last couple games or whatever, it may or may not be possible that we could either see that from him up and at it though, or Riz could probably get back his composure and do the same exact thing though that Wraith was doing before.
Yeah.
So it's definitely...
Keep in mind, when Riz won his games, they were either SD or just not a good character, right?
Yeah, it could be either one though. Honestly though, I mean, the worst thing you can ever do is SD.
Yeah.
And especially with a character that has a pretty solid recovery. Like, Bayonetta's got like a bunch of jumps or whatever. I think she has 3.
Yeah.
And
that is a mentality killer right there, especially when you mess up with that.
It's worse when it's on a character that can't really recover, because if you're a character that can't recover, then there's no way, like, you should ever overcommit, because unless you're like 99% sure you're gonna get that kill. Now if you're like Bayonetta or Meta Knight or any other characters that have a better recovery and whatnot though, as per se, then you're able to just like be able to commit fully and then just get back on.
Yeah.
Which that's important too.
Yeah, we have Meta Knight at kill percentage right now. And doesn't look good for Riz, unfortunately.
Just bringing it back though, like you can tell though, like he still has that momentum from the past couple games.
And he's still trying, still putting in the heart.
Yeah, he's putting it in there, and Riz is just continuing not to give up though, even if he has lost a stock and whatnot. Like, he's definitely very capable of taking a stock right there, like what we just saw there.
He just tied up the match.
Exactly. And like I said though, from earlier though, Meta Knight Sword Smash is definitely a really good pressuring tool because of just, I don't know what it can do in reality per se. And what's important about that though is if you can apply pressure with Meta Knight, you are literally Meta Knight.
Yeah.
And for Bayonetta, if you know more than just roofies, then you're okay though. Like, people say that Bayonetta is arguably the best character in the game, but she's definitely not flawless by any means. Like, for one, she's like really tall and she has a big hitbox or whatever goes, so she can get hit by like a bunch of stuff unless like you have Bat Within to kind of like save your day and everything. So
wow, 55. The rage came into play right here. 55.
Man, I was able to make a clutch move right there. So good stuff to Riz on that early kill right there, though. Mm-hmm. Like, wow. I usually see that kill, though, if he does a combo thing. That one, he just whipped it out, and then he just, like, I'm just going to use the move like nobody's business. And then just, what are you going to do, right?
And the score is right now 1-0.
It is 1-0 right now in the bracket reset.
Mm-hmm.
So this is game two of the bracket reset right now, which means either way, it can either be anyone's game or it can be very one-sided. In my opinion, it's definitely anybody's game because you never know whether people are going to have momentum or not, people are going to just do anything else in particular.
Well, I hope maybe that one game, that previous game, might have been gone in favor for Riz with his momentum right now.
Exactly.
He looks pretty cheered up. He looks like he's in.
Yeah, he's just trying to go in and whatnot, and Bayonetta and whatnot, just trying to bait out the witch time that is currently going on. So, what could happen though is that both characters can get a bait and punish.
Yeah.
And they both work in completely different ways. A good DI right there from Wraith. Yeah. Good DI.
We thought that might have been, and he tried to go for another one.
Yeah, he DI'd away.
And the dimensional cape and
spicy read.
Mm-hmm. Ends Bayonetta stop. Well cooked.
Very, very, very spicy with some jalapenos and those habanero hot sauce and ghost peppers.
Yep.
The spicier it is, the better the read it is. Like, spicy.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, like, we are now trying to see that. Right now, we are trying to see that Riz is just keeping his composure with going on, with trying to be able to keep up with,
SD.
The one thing you don't want to have in Smash 4 is SD, you know. Especially considering that it is two stocks, and losing a stock is just absolutely huge.
And you're going against Bayonetta, too.
Exactly, and if you don't know that matchup, and you don't have any way to capitalize, then that could just be really troublesome.
Look at that, Wraith is bringing it back. What can he do? Let's see his combo going up, and will this end the match? And
Nah, you're like, is this it? Nah, man. So, right
Riz,
now...
Riz looks like he's playing a little shaky. And that might end it. Yeah, it's 1-1.
It's 1-1 right now, so we are in a tie game right now. We are in a tie game right now.
Tie game right now. We're still it's best 3 out of 5.
So it's good. So it's. So, it's really coming in rather close, honestly, though. So it, and then when you're like, confident, you think these guys are doing this on purpose?
Yeah. We are having a little time constraints. We thought it was gonna end quick, but now they're just going at it.
Yeah, man. I mean. You can tell it's either you're seeing, you're either seeing like a really hyped set, which is actually a pretty good set for the most part. Because like when you see a bracket reset and it goes to game 5, whatever, you know you have a good set.
Mm-hmm.
That's the one thing I've learned though throughout all my years of ever like knowing if tournaments and whatnot. Because I play more, I play more towards like Tekken and all that other stuff. Smash Bros. I just play like for fun and just to like help people with getting better at the game and knowing what to do, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, all of that, though, has, like, applied to playing Smash in particular.
Yeah, and right here, Riz, with a nice little air combo. Didn't work well. Well, it worked, but didn't kill.
Exactly. Like, I'd just be a bigger, like, a smaller ceiling, whatever. There's a possibility that it could have might have, because you've seen the previous games, though, to where Meta Knight was able to kill at 55, overwhelmingly early here and there. Now, there is one thing, though, that you will notice, though, about Smashville, though, that is a little bit weird.
Yeah.
The edges to left and right sides or whatever, if you hit people with anything, it gets them from below. Like, this is the stage itself, though. Like, they imagine, like, this is the ledge.
Mm-hmm.
And you try to get something from above right here, people can get hit. From there, like, Mitsu can do it, Bayo can do it, Ike can do it, a lot of people can do it.
Yeah, you see right now, Bayonetta took a stock. from one of them right now. With a nice little well-timed up air.
Possibly could be even.
Any type? No.
Yeah, that was probably the sour spot.
Yeah.
Because you can tell that's the sour spot, because had that been a sweet spot, that would have done a trick.
And let's see what he can do. No, mashing out right there. Good job by Wraith.
Yeah, that does quite a bit of damage though. Like, I feel like when Bale's at rage or whatever though, she can get her combos to go on a lot more smoothly.
Yeah.
And that is, and yes, I will say this though, it is something that can be argued.
Mm-hmm.
But like every Bayonetta player is completely different though in terms of playstyle.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why I'm like, okay, I can't say that you can't say like this and that Bale is bad, because like they all play just so differently from one another. And What you will definitely notice and whatever is like, look at how each of these Bayo players are playing, look how everyone else is playing, look how Wraith is playing. You're not gonna get any similarities at all though. Like, it'll just be nothing more than a complete difference though between like what you or your character are just trying to do in that way.
So we have here final stock on game 3. I remember both of these characters are ones that could kill really early, and this looks like it might be for that, Riz. And yes, it is.
That is 2-1, right?
Well done. Well done.
Well done, Wraith, though. He's trying to get that momentum back up, and I'm not going to lie, though. I feel like they might take this to Game 5 on purpose just to keep us here.
I see that.
It might be that, though. But, I mean, like, because of, like, the way both play against each other, it's, like, hard to tell.
Yeah.
But, like, considering
they might have their own little script going on. Mm-hmm.
Exactly, though. Like, and this record, Smash 4 is not scripted. That's what they know. Melee is secretly scripted. Many people know this. What? Why do you hate both of them?
Give him a ticket. Alright then, so we are on to game 4, right? Game 4?
Game 4, yes.
And that is up 2. This could be it. This could be the final game.
Wraith is up 2-1 right now.
Mm-hmm. Riz almost caught her with the up B.
That could have been. That probably could have been it right there.
And now Bayonetta retaliating with her own combo. And wow, this is a pretty intense game going on right now.
It is, and it's not even game 5 of all things.
Yeah.
It's like it could either be it.
And that is it for Riz. Like, this is his last stop.
Like, that's the thing though. It's like it could either be it,
mm-hmm.
or it could just.
It could
be something else.
Oh. What it looks like right now, Bayonetta has this game set, down packed, as Riz completely downloaded.
Download complete? Not quite yet.
Not quite yet. Probably 70%, I'd say 60-70,
give or take.
Yeah. But no, Riz could come back at any moment. Remember, he's using Meta Knight, the one that could up air you to death. Up air you and up D.
Oh my goodness.
Let's see what can happen here. Ooh.
Oh, if that was a spike though, that would have been it right there.
Could have been perfectly cooked.
That would have been like, okay, no, that's just, okay, no, that's just illegal pepper spicy.
Yeah.
That's how that's
pepper spray spicy.
Like, don't even get me started, man. You know how it is when it comes to characters like this.
Riz still fighting here, not giving up. Oop. And the jab kills.
Surprisingly, like, who would have thought that they would have that much knockback?
Mm-hmm.
But anywho, so this is definitely still anybody's game, in my opinion, though. Like, Meta Knight just has to get a little more momentum.
And wow, the jab reset did not work there.
Nah, because, like, if you're on the stage or whatever, though, it gets you out of that.
Could the forward air kill here? No. Oh, my
what
goodness.
What was that?
That was some weird DI to end the set.
DI questionable?
Oh, and that is it. Wraith takes the Wraith tournament.
Wraith just takes it, though.
Congratulations to Wraith, winning the second iteration of Kingdom.
Who won the last one, by the way?
I do not remember, actually. It was a round robin last week, though, and I wasn't here.
Oh, you weren't here. Okay. This is my first one here, too, because I literally just found out about it because someone wanted me to come here.
Yeah.
So,
unfortunately, you got here a little late. You couldn't join Brad.